Hey, mis amores, how are you? I hope you guys are doing well. So we are going to get into a general reading for you guys to see what comes through, what you guys need to know, and we'll go from there. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. First, I'm going to pull a message from the fortune reading cards, see what comes through for you guys. Let's see, what do we have for the collective? We have coffin. Look at that. I love how it like matches my background. Okay, so this is about natural endings taking place. It says take care of your health as well. Okay, so let's read into that and see what this means for you guys. Let me grab my stand really quick. Okay. All right, so some of you guys could be ending relationships. Some of you guys could be needing to put an end to unhealthy habits, especially eating habits and stuff like that, because it's affecting your health. Perhaps you're ending it with love interest, people, coworkers, frenemies, because they're just taking too much of your energy, okay? It often means a long wait for something or someone close to your heart. It can also refer to the feeling that you are not getting anywhere and time is slipping away. It can appear when life feels very stagnant and everything seems to be on hold. You may feel trapped, like your life is out of control. Some of you may be trying to find a way out of a tricky situation. It could also indicate a fear of not getting what you want. This card can be a cautious card regarding your health or a family member's. It's time to take better care of yourself and your well-being and get the necessary checkups as soon as possible. This card could also indicate a person who has been ill for a while may pass over, but it will be expected and a natural transition. This won't be unexpected and it's not to be feared. Now, when it comes to your personal life and your relationships, a person or a professional relationship that has proved difficult is about to end. You will make a decision about whether to continue with it once and for all. The relationship has probably been toxic in your life for some time, and ending it for the best for everyone concerned is for the best for everyone concerned. So be brave. Now, when it comes to career and money, there may be delays surrounding your progress in your career, business, or even financially. Money that is waiting is on its way, or money that you are waiting on is causing you stress, actually. This card can also mean that a project or goal doesn't seem as important as before. And for some, you know, there you could get unexpected money if you have been having troubles. So a project or a goal doesn't seem as important as it used to before, or one that is just too hard to reach will finish or become a dead end. Also, be aware that, you know what, sometimes when you start something, you were in that energy and then you start to realize, you know what, this isn't for me anymore, so I'm going to shift to something else. It's not that you're giving up, but you got into it knowing that, you know what, I have this idea and this and that, and then later on you're like, you know, I tried it and it's not for me, and it's okay that you move past it. You don't have to force it because you're like, oh, I have to finish it because I started it. For some, that's the case. For others, you know what, it's okay. Maybe you're coming to a completion of something and you're finally going to be able to not stress over that situation anymore. Okay, so that is the first card. Now let's move forward. Let's see what else is coming through. We're actually going to pull a card from my Witchy Way Oracle. You guys can find this in my Etsy shop. This is a big deck as well. Thank you. We have music heals. And actually, that's very true. Okay, so it says, no matter what you are feeling or going through, music and its beautiful sound waves will help heal and uplift your energy. Find the music that speaks to your soul and allow it to work its magic on you. Okay, so whenever you're in some type of mood, whether you're angry, feeling melancholy, you're stressed out, put on your favorite music. That always helps me. Sometimes I'll be like, oh, I don't want to do nothing today. And as soon as I hear that one gem, I'm like, I want to do every fucking thing. Okay? Music does heal. You know, some of you guys might benefit from, what is that thing called? It's a specific, a pitchfork. Some of you guys might benefit using a pitchfork. And the sound frequency and waves to heal something in your body, to heal any negative blockages or remove any negative blockages. I'm telling you, also sound bowls as well can also help remove any nasty stagnant energy and help obviously your chakras align as well. Okay, so there's a lot of healing benefits when it comes to sound. All right, so I'm gonna grab another one. Angel of Compassion. Ooh, look at how beautiful her dress is. Kind of matches my background too. So here it says, how are you showing compassion in a world that lacks it? Spirit is asking you to be an angel for someone who could use a little bit of attention and care when others don't. A pet, senior citizen, the homeless, etc. Be an angel of compassion. You know, there's not a lot of people out there that really care for other people's well-being, or if they're doing okay, if they need help, if they need assistance, have they ate today, have they had enough water, you know, is something bothering you? It's very rare that everybody has that. Well, we all have that one person that does care for us and family members that do care for us, but then there's not a lot of people out there that have what others are fortunate to have. You know, so if you know someone that doesn't really have anybody, you know, they're going through something, you know, be an angel of the day for them. If you see a senior citizen that has like a living situation where all they do is just sit in a chair all day, say, you know what, I'm going to take you to the beach today, or I'm going to take you to lunch today. You know, make somebody's day. You never know how much joy you might bring into that person's life. Okay. It's the little things that count. It's the little things that make you an angel in somebody else's eyes. Okay, so now we're going to get into the Witch's Kitchen deck, which is interesting because I haven't used this deck in a while, so I was really guided to use it. Okay, so let's see what comes through. Actually, we gotta go to the grocery store after this. Grab some coffee first. Take my nephew with me. And get some shit done. You know? I'm a wifey and a mother too. Besides being a guide in Tarot Land. Oh, and a mom of a puppy. And 3 German Shepherds, of course. Alright, guys, here we go. Ooh. Oh my goodness. We have power, ginger. Oh my God, I love ginger. It's super strong, but it's so good. So let's read what this says for you guys, okay? Look at the little gingerbread. I love it. Ginger ale. Ginger ale is really good. I don't care what anybody says. I love ginger ale. It's pretty damn good. All right, let's see what this says. We're going to leave right now. Okay, so the power says, if you found that your magical abilities have waned lately or wish to add more piquancy to your spell work, Then allow me to assist. My forceful and fiery influence will help to accelerate the results you desire. Ooh, for the power of my root has been revered since ancient times. When you are down, or when someone tries to overshadow or bully you, your personal power fades. Add some ginger magic into your world and turn up the heat. Ah, oh, bitch, it's on and popping now. I will bring you the confidence to live up to your full potential, period. Your power increases. Together we shall combat nightmares, especially if you're dealing with, you know, it could be. Especially if you're dealing with Freddy Krueger ass haters, right? It's just funny. I recently mentioned something like that. Anyways, together we shall combat nightmares, incite passion, and heal physical ailments such as stomach and digestive problems. In addition to spicing up your culinary delights in the kitchen, my medicinal properties offer anti-inflammatory and antioxidant effects for healing the body. Ooh, look at that. So interesting how we ended up having the coffin card, which is about endings, right? You could put an end to the bullshit. You can use ginger, maybe even ginger root too, teas, the herb. You can make a juice out of it. You could put it in your spell work. It's interesting how that came out with the death card, with the coffin card, and we also had the music heals. So we have a lot of healing energy going on here, or the need to find some type of healing or balance, especially if you're going through a lot right now. I'm also picking up a lot of you guys are experiencing headaches. Okay. Make sure to drink a lot of water. I've been finding myself like really obsessed with sparkling water, especially the grapefruit. Okay, we have hemp. Oh, shit. You ain't gotta tell us twice. We got expansion, okay? Ooh, I love this. So listen, it's funny because when I was at the store the other day, some man walked in and it smelled like pure weed. And apparently he was like the manager to like this hemp shop. And everybody was like, ooh, y'all hiring? Yeah, woo. It like instantly put everybody in a good mood and shit. It was so funny. So let's go ahead and read the hemp card. I'm also hearing hemp to hump. Someone is, okay, hemp to hump. You know, hemp is also used to heal like pain and stuff like that. It helps you to get off of certain medications as well. So it says, you've been courting controversy, although what you're standing for is right. If only others could see the point you are making. Exactly. Thinking outside of the box or looking at the bigger picture is the only way forward. Although looking at a situation from another's viewpoint will help you understand the approach and attitude of others at this time. My good reputation is often disputed, even though I've been used for textiles and rope for thousands of years. Nowadays, my flowers and seeds are used in health foods, organic body care, and other nutraceuticals. And I'm loved by vegans for my natural protein benefits and essential fatty acids. Time to keep an open mind when I appear. Although my THC levels will not affect you like my cousin cannabis, my family holds the secrets of the universe to expand your consciousness. Ooh, look at that, darling. You see that? Hey, sometimes people use like cannabis and all that stuff, marijuana, to help channel. I know some people that channel and dig deeper into esoteric knowledge and receive all kinds of info better. You tap in better when you're on certain type of, you know, drugs and medicines and stuff like that. I mean, it's some of the greatest people that you've ever heard about that tapped into other worlds and dimensions. It's because they took some type of herb, you know, some type of medicine, and it really helps you tap into certain things. So maybe that could help some of you, especially if you struggle with headaches or every time you feel like you tap in and the energy is just too much for you. Maybe hemp will help you out. Hemp with some music, sound frequency, all that put together, honey. Ooh, you'd be golden. You'd be walking on sunshine. And girl is going to be feeling good, period. Okay, so, ooh, look at the bottom of the deck, bitch. I want some pie now. We got blackberry. Look at the wine. Wine, dine, have a good old time. You know what? I'm going to read that because I'm curious to see what that says. So the blackberry. Somebody is desperate to be part of your life and could be pushing your buttons right now. Oh my God. You know what? Even when our haters are constantly mentioning us and bringing us up, it's because they miss us, bitch. They want to be part of our world. I can't. I was literally like telling my friend Mamina. She was singing, I want to be where the people aren't. And I was like, I want to be where the karmics aren't. I want to see them drowning. No, I'm just kidding. But anyways, I thought it was funny that that came out. Anyways, here it says, the people that want to be in your life are pushing your buttons right now. They're triggering you, or at least trying to, you know. I always say they're like little kids in kindergarten that throw tantrums when they don't get things their way. It's like, can somebody give them some melatonin? They need a nap. Triple it on that bitch, you know. So it says their invasive presence and a blatant disrespect of your boundaries is making you feel uncomfortable. Neighbor disputes could be an issue for you as boundary lines are crossed, or you may be fighting for personal space at work. Time to break away and free yourself from an entrapment and attachments of others and heal from anything that is causing you unease. You see, there's that word again, unease and heal. If you permit, I shall protect you from unwanted invasion with my thorny branches. Plant me in your garden to prevent energy vampires from crossing your threshold. Oh, fuck yeah, honey. Let's swim in that shit. And if my thorns draw the perpetrator's blood, as dark and juicy as my berries, then you can be sure that justice is served. Bitch, this fucking card is so dark, and I fucking love this card. Hands down, I didn't expect it from this beautiful, sweet-looking card. She is the shit. Yes, honey, we need some blackberry now, right? Shove it down those bitches' throat. Anyways, that was no wonder why I was guided to use all these cards together. Yo, what are the odds of these messages coming through right now? Okay, so let's go ahead and put this aside. And I'm going to pull one from my daughter's deck. Okay, this is a deck that my daughter created last year. And it's called Puff Puff Pass Oracle. All right, so let's go ahead and see what comes through for you guys. Oh, I got a few of them here. We have White Rhino. Okay. Here it says, you're too much of a bad bitch for emotions. Yo. I cannot right now. See, that's why I'm like, some of you guys could be going through it right now. You need lots of healing. You need a woosah. Some people are trying you. People are trying to get under your skin. Some people are obsessed with you. Maybe they're in love with you type of energy, right? But guess what? Spirit's like, you're too much of a bad bitch for emotions, okay? Even though some people be having you triggered, you got to remember, we are in Cancer season. People are going to be in their feels. People are going to come back and poke an old wound just because they're bored. Just because they didn't eat well that day or some shit. You know what I mean? So, I love that card. And then we have medical marijuana. Here it says, you need some fucking healing in your life, bitch. Look at that. Again, healing. That's like the main thing in this message. Some of y'all need some healing. Some of you guys, maybe you're not over some shit. Maybe you need help. Maybe your haters need help, right? Or maybe your haters could use a little hit of this because they're stressing you out. Or maybe you're stressing them out. And because you're stressing them out, because you're living life thriving, being in good energy, they have to come in and just prove to you that they're miserable. Ooh, that could be directed towards someone. As I said that, I just saw 2020 on the screen. Hey! All right? So that is what's coming through, you guys. I hope you enjoy the message. I hope you guys have a wonderful 4th of July. And if you guys want to book a reading, I am taking readings for next week, this upcoming week. And I will only be booking emergency readings until Sunday, okay? So I hope you guys enjoy. Bless you. Bye.